So welcome to the first video in several. I'm going to be building an Epee DLG. It's a 1 meter DLG. I happened to pick up one of the last carbon fiber wings here. It's made by a gentleman named Paul Phillips down in North Carolina. And these wings are all custom made by him, hand done. Here you can see the tail feathers. Horizontal surface. And the vertical stabilizer. And I'll be walking through all of the parts that I have in the kit, as well as what I ordered, and going over a few of the preparations that I made to the plane while I was waiting for some of the parts to arrive. And then I will show you how I build this kit. Here we have the wing. I requested Paul, before he stopped doing custom colors, that he make a green and pink wing to match all of the other planes that I've been doing with a green and pink theme. He also was kind enough to drill out a hole for the throwing peg. Standard, he does cut the ailerons for you as well as the mounting holes. You can see the design here. Here's the vertical stabilizer. Horizontal stabilizer. You can see Paul pre-drills the holes here. Here's the throwing peg. Nice and simple. Now I did take it and I sealed it up with CA glue, so it's got a little bit of a shine, and then I roughed it up again with some sandpaper. I ended up ordering D47 servos, but there are other servos that are less expensive and still are fitting quite well. The standard battery for the Epee is a Nanotech 300 milliamp battery for 1S operation. This is a sheet of G10 that was provided to me so that way I can cut my own control horns. This is some micro balloons. These are glass micro balloons for mixing with the epoxy. This is for embedding the throwing peg into the wing. Here we have the nose cone. This is made of fiberglass layup with a smoked paint job to make it a little darker, matching the rest of the body. I did a little light sanding on the edges here and then sealed that with some thin CA glue. Here we have the fuselage. Paul went ahead and mounted the horizontal stabilizer mount for me and drilled it out. He's now using some 3D printed mounts. You can see the eyelet cut for the control rod control line there, as well as here for the ailerons. Now all three of those holes I filed out a little bit and then sealed up with some CA glue, as well as the edges here and here in the nose. This hole in the nose is for dropping some putty for balance. Here we have the receiver plug or jack that's going to be mounted inside the fuselage. And this will be the plug that'll go into it for charging. Control wire, spring for the horizontal stabilizer, elevator control surface, screws. I ordered some tungsten putty per Paul's recommendation. This is for adding weight or ballast to the plane at the right spots and being able to cram it in there. And then this is some finishing epoxy that I got. This will be useful for laying up the little bit of fiberglass on the tail feathers, or the carbon fiber strips on the tail feathers, as well as inserting the throwing peg into the wing. As you can see, there's not a whole lot to the kit. It's quite minimal. It is a DLG after all, so there's not really much to it. There's no motor, there's not really much there other than the couple of servos and battery. So I'm gonna go ahead and get started on the build and show you guys what I get done. First thing that I'll be doing is I'll be mounting this throwing peg right into this wing tip. It's already been cut and drilled so that way it slides in there easily. Just like so. So all I need to do is mix up some epoxy and micro balloons, fill in this gap around the edges, and that should be set. By weight, I did 3/4 of a gram of the finishing hardener and 3/4 of a gram of the finishing resin. And then I added enough micro balloons until I got about this level of consistency here. And it ended up being about 2 teaspoons of micro balloons. Now that the micro balloons and epoxy mixture is made, I've already attached the throwing peg with a few drops of CA glue to hold it in place, so that way I can fill this gap here and get it loaded up and secure. Once you have the throwing peg completely filled with the micro balloons epoxy mixture, you want to go ahead and wipe away the excess so that way when you peel back the tape, you're left with a nice clean seal. Handy to have something else to wipe your fingers on. That's disposable. Once you are happy with the amount of fill that you have in around your throwing peg, you can go ahead and remove the masking tape to allow it the rest of the epoxy to dry clean. Once you've removed the masking tape and inspected for any excess smudges that might overrun and cleaned it off, go ahead and set the wing aside and allow this to cure overnight so that way the peg is nice and strong in there and you don't have any issues with it. Next thing I did was create my control horns here. I've got my aileron control horns matched up to each other. And once they're sitting in the wing, there should be about 5 millimeters between the surface of the wing and the hole for the control horn. Here is the elevator control horn. This is going to be also upside down, and it's going to be pulling this direction on it, which is why I looped it. This too is also at about 5 millimeters for where the end of the circle is. For CA glue, I'm using some Super Gold Plus because it says it's 100% foam safe, whereas the normal Super Gold just says foam safe. So after my testing with the low voltage of the two receivers, I had already decided to go with the X4R, but I hadn't noticed the difference in amperage between the two receivers. While this D4R is rated for about 60 milliamp current, and the X4R is rated for about 100 milliamp current, and my testing confirmed this. So for my current choice of battery, which is a 300 milliamp 1S battery, I think it'll be a lot safer for using the D4R2 in the Epee. Otherwise, you'll be putting a little bit more stress on the battery with the X4R, and you'll shorten your flight time. So if you have a really good afternoon, you may end up starting to puff your battery just a little bit. So I'll be depinning the D4R2 receiver and then installing that in the Epee instead of the X4R receiver. So anywhere else in the video that you notice that I say X4R, it's because I had already filmed that section of the video before swapping over to the D4R2. So otherwise, they are more or less the exact same size. I'll be depinning them the same way and removing the smart port plastic connector as well as the paper case to save space and weight. When installing the servos, it's a good idea to try and tape them together like this. This way you can epoxy or glue them into place and just cut out around the tape to make replacing them a little bit easier. Now, the way I have them set up, this is the elevator servo. It'll tuck in underneath the saddle a bit. And here are the two aileron servos. They're right next to each other to keep the control rod similar length. Here we have the fuselage and the servo tray. And once you tape up your servos for installation, you can use them to mark out your alignment for cutting. Before you cut though, you're going to want to make sure you measure how far back the battery, or how far forward the battery can actually fit inside the nose. For me, it was about 45 millimeters back from the tip of the nose as to where the battery ended up. So what I had to do was cut out a tray back to about 45 millimeters back. I ended up cutting it farther than that, so what I had to do was patch it with a little bit of fiberglass and CA glue. So what I'll do now is sand out a little channel on either side to allow wires to run across and up and make it to the receiver. I've removed the paper casing from the D4R2 receiver, and the next thing I'll do is depin it and remove this plastic connector here. Yeah, what I'll do here is I'll slide this off, all of the pins, and then I'll just take the soldering iron and pull them out individually. To slide these plastic spacers off, all you have to do is get a small screwdriver and work it underneath and work it up from both sides nice and evenly. There. Now it's a lot easier to depin this. Okay, here we have the D4R2, and it's been depinned, and I've removed the plastic sensor port connector here. So it's ready to be connected in, and I've already test fitted it, so I know it all works. I had to tie the antennas into knots in order to shorten them a little bit. This way, when they go into the fuselage, they won't be sticking into the carbon fiber section of the fuselage. They'll stay into the fiberglass section, which is RF transparent. Well, that's going to wrap it up for part one. Made a lot of progress in 24 hours. I've also got the nose pod finished up, so I need to mount the servos. And I'll be wiring up the servos to the receiver, as well as going over the pinout for the power jack, mounting some of the stabilizers, and whatever else we'll be able to get to in video two. So hopefully you enjoyed this video, and keep watching. Stay tuned for the next ones, and we will finish this Epee build up here soon enough.